Hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Blabbercast. I'm your host, Cameron, and with me, as always, is my co-host and author of The Nicest Parts of Hell, Billy. What up, Billy?
Cameron, what is going on? We are going to try to do this show.
I don't know. Let's
see. Leading up to this week, we were like, yeah, it's going to be cool. We'll do topics, you know, take a little break from retrospectives, which we'll get back to next week. But it's all right, yeah. Yeah, topics you want to talk about?
No.
We'll think of something. You know? Yeah, we'll think of something every day. We'll think of something. I just don't care about like anything going on in the world. Like, I mean, I care about, you know, bad things happen. That sucks. But I look at shit and it's like, yeah, this streamer did this. And I don't know who the fuck that is. I don't care.
Who?
Yeah. So I'm like, don't know who that is. Don't care. Don't care. So we'll just figure it out.
Yeah, for those of you that don't know, Blabbercast originally started out as just like a regular kind of video podcast thing where we just talk about stuff, upcoming movies, books, just whatever was on our mind. And we didn't, me and Billy are just movie hounds and we love movies and TV and books, obviously. And so we just kind of started talking about movies, and that was just like our go-to thing. We did a topic video about a month or two ago and wasn't like, didn't set the world on fire as far as numbers goes, but we had some people that liked it, and so we're like, yeah, we gotta do that again. And we kind of just got into our flow of doing movies and whatnot, checking out Hellraiser, Child's Play, and whatnot. It was fun. It was a blast. It's what me and Billy like to do. But we decided top of the month, we need to kick the month off with a topic video. Just sit back, chill, talk. And we're sat down trying to think of ideas, what to talk about. And like Billy said, there's nothing to talk about. I
don't know, it's weird. Well, I see people like do these and they'll do like little 7-8 minute videos, and I just don't care. I won't say names or anything, it's fine, but and I'm looking and it's like, man, they're really getting like fucking 8 million views for that. Like, okay, I mean, that's cool. I mean, I'm just like, I don't know, every time we done topic videos it's like 50, 60. I'm not going to pay attention to it this week because I saw comments or something. But
we have a micro ecosystem that we judge success on.
Yeah, basically. If I crack 100 on this, I'd be shocked. I mean, something we can talk about though, I guess. So is the Thanksgiving trailer?
Yes. Yes.
So I saw this many years ago.
Yep.
You remember this Grindhouse Films? I think it was at What was it? I can't remember the names of them now. It was Planet Terror, and then
Planet Terror, Death Proof, and then eventually they made Machete out of into one, two of them actually, and that was another like a fake movie commercial before the films, starring Danny Trejo, and that was the trailers were awesome, and the movies were actually really good too. I loved them.
Yeah, it was interesting. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, I haven't seen those yet, but I should. But this, I remember watching, it was in theater, my, you know, the back to back. It's pretty cool. It's like, oh, 2007. So you did see this trailer for Thanksgiving, and it was like, it's just, I don't even remember, you know, this Thanksgiving, be prepared to be stuffed. Cooked and dead. It's just really ridiculous. The voice actor was like our deepest voice ever. And I remember thinking that they do this thing and the guy's like touching the ground and like licks his fingers. And he's like, one cop, it's blood. The other cop, son of a bitch. And I'm like, they have to make this exact movie. just looked over the top stupid, but I'm like, they have to make this shit.
Yeah, and, it was in the style of the Grindhouse genre. So
yeah, but so that's, it's based on a mock trailer obviously from Grindhouse 2007. Eli Roth directed the Thanksgiving trailer, and that was between Planet Terror and Death Proof. They were a double feature. In an interview, here's a couple factoids you always have them, with Total Film Magazine filmmaker Eli Roth, he said that the film isn't meant to be a film that was advertised in Grindhouse, which I was like, fuck. quote, we said, let's pretend Thanksgiving was a movie from 1980 that was so offensive that every print was destroyed. All scripts were burned. The director disappeared. The crew members changed their names. One person saved the trailer and uploaded it to the darkest corners of 4chan. And now it's made. And now it's made it out. So this is a 2023 reboot. Once we said that, it freed us up. Which I like Eli Roth. I didn't quite still understand.
Of course.
Like, well, I mean, I'm still not understanding that. I'm like, why can't you just make what you had? I mean,
yeah.
You know, so I don't know if this is going to be kind of like a cheesy one. They're going to kind of do that half serious horror thing. I just think you should have made it overly ridiculous because I think you would have had, you know, a little bit of a franchise out of just making it just totally stupid. You know?
From the trailer, it looks like it's, you know, a more modern, earnest take on something kind of like Scream, like in a sense, you know, where it's, you know, it's a kind of an enclosed town and ensemble cast, and it's just like any horror movie, and you watch one get picked off at a time, and yeah, someone hiding behind a mask and whatnot. So yeah, unfortunately, it's not. I don't think it's going to have that grindhouse flavor to it. But you know, it is what it is. It reminds me, I got to go buy the Machete movies because I've got Death Proof and Planet Terror on like three different formats. I love those movies.
Yeah, so, they were good. They were awesome. They stood out very well. Yeah, that's hopeful. I mean, it might be okay, but yeah, I said they've covered every holiday. That's pretty much every holiday now. I guess St. Patrick's Day. Don't know if they've done that one.
I guess you could say it's the Leprechaun movies.
Yeah, we'll just say those close enough. You know, Valentine, they did do that sort of.
Mm-hmm.
So I noticed it had Denise Richards in it, so I was okay with it.
That's definitely a reason to watch.
That's what I remember about the movie. So that's
about it. Yeah, exactly.
It wasn't that bad, I guess.
All I remember about Leprechaun was Jennifer Aniston. So.
Yeah, and she doesn't want anything to do with it either. It's weird.
Oh, really?
I heard that anyway. She's like, I don't know. It's one of those. I mean, everyone has their things, but it's whatever, dude. It was your first movie. Who cares? You know?
Probably because she had her original nose.
Yeah, there
you go. I know. I'm serious. I think she, from what I remember, I think she had a nose job after that movie.
Yeah, after that, yeah. Maybe that could be it. Yeah.
But it's weird. I mean, they made fun of that on Friends quite a bit. Her character having a nose job. So whatever.
Yeah.
No big deal. Yeah. I'm looking forward to that movie quite a bit, Thanksgiving. I definitely want to watch that. I won't be able to watch it on Thanksgiving. When does it come out again?
Oh God! You asked me to write it down. I have to look it up. Yeah. Well, I don't know if I'm looking forward to it or not. Because I wanted the one they showed. So I can't ever watch.
Well, yeah.
I wanted that exact movie to come out, and I'm all bummed out now.
So. I don't blame you. So yeah. Oh, well, okay. It doesn't come out on Thanksgiving.
Comes out December 24th.
Yeah. Comes out on Groundhog's Day, November 17th. So,
okay, well, close enough.
Yeah, it's not.
Oh my God, that original trailer is so good. Anyway, I got to get over it. Oh, go ahead. Sorry.
No, I never thought that they would make fucking Machete. You know, that was like something like 10 years afterwards. So,
Yeah, it was a while. Rob Zombie with the SS's werewolves and some shit. Should make that
Overlord or some shit.
I was like SS werewolves of Simon. I mean, I should probably write it down. I don't remember. Fuck it. I'm trying to remember the top of my head. I can't do it. I am on the internet. I could look it up, but I don't feel like it.
Too bad we don't want to talk about it, right?
Too bad we don't talk about anything. We're just filling space.
Hey, do you want to talk about it? No.
No.
Yeah. It's like, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on in the world right now, and you know, especially over in Israel and stuff, but I'm not informed enough to talk about that kind of crap. And it's just like,
I'm not informed enough to talk about it. Yeah. And then two, I'm like, I don't really, I mean, dude, I mean, people come here to have hopefully a good time, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. It's a place.
It's kind of like, and one thing I noticed, this is kind of interesting. You go like to, if a actor like has passed recently and you go see a movie scene that you like, I don't like going to the comments because everything is like, you know, rest in peace, rest in peace, rest in peace. It's like, God, I know I'm just bummed out, bro. Man, like, can we talk about the scene a little bit? Like, yeah, we get it. He's dead. He's passed on. We get it.
Yeah. Yeah,
rest in peace, man. Yeah, bro. Rest in peace. I'm like, dude, motherfuckers just got random funerals. Like, my condolences. It's like, well, I mean, you know, I mean, that's fine to show your respect, but I mean, I still kind of like to talk about the scene. You know, I think we differ on this in opinion. That's just cool. But yeah, I always just say I don't really talk it like, you know, if they pass or not. I talk like they're still around because I think it's a more of a positive thing. You know, it's like, yeah, we get it. It's like, yeah, but you're going to die. It's like, yeah, I know that. Yeah, but you're really going to die. I'm like, you're going to fucking die. I'm like, I know. Eventually, yes, we all will. You know, so thanks for reminding me every 5 seconds. It's like they go intentionally to go to the comment section to write that shit. I wish there was like another pushback group that's like, yeah, dude, we know they died. We get it. And just get that that famous YouTube argument. Okay, man, it'd be a dick. It's like, well, we get it. They're fucking, you know.
And you have some like angsty, jaded Call of Duty player just, you know, prestiged off of his couch. And he's all like getting on your shit because you didn't recognize a sound effect from Call of Duty 79.
That's a whole other one. There's a couple other things that we do have. I found some stuff to talk about. So Netflix. Flix obviously increased their price recently. Apple just did theirs as well. So their Apple One, which is pretty to me decent deal with Apple TV and Apple Music. Then you had storage and all that shit. I think that's going to $22.95. It's a random number to $25.95.
Was that
for and Apple? That's for Apple, yeah. The thing with Apple TV is though, I'm not saying the last show I started to watch it, it's fine. I'm not like jerking it off. I mean, it's like fine. It's not bad. It's not great to me. It's good. There's like a few, but there's not that much on there. So, and they're trying to get $9.99 a month if that's separate. I'm like, bro, there's not really anything there. If they threw a whole bunch of old movies, like Tubi, I shouldn't say this. I'm going to try to do it. Sorry if this happens.
It's going
to
fuck it up.
It's going to fuck it up, but
it's going to fuck it up.
$10 a month for Tubi. I'm like, no ads. I'm like, yeah, that's perfect. That's what I like to watch.
Yeah.
Instead of like, hey, look, there's a new show. I'm like, I don't care. It's the same formulaic shit that comes out time and time again. Yeah, there might be some good ones that come out, but yeah, I don't know. Just seeing those things are going up. Like, there's more. I wonder if it's ever going to come back down. That's the other thing. Is it?
Fuck no.
Is that? I guess not. I mean, eventually, though, you think it would bottom out and you would start seeing that because I'm shocked that Hulu's even gotten up to almost 17, 20.
I just got rid of Hulu and it was $17.99 a month.
It's just too much. I get it. They're not getting very much money though. I do get it because say random show on Hulu is only on DVD, right? All right, 1 million people go buy the DVD. It's a popular show. That's a lot more revenue than streaming. You don't make that much off streaming. So I get that aspect of it, but I don't know. Maybe you have some kind of like a deal. It's like, yeah, you can buy the show the whole season for just, you know, $3, you know, $4 or $5. But then you have the DRM problem, though, which would be another issue.
Well, I think it's all stemming or there. It's a preemptive thing for the writer's strike. I think that's still going on, if I'm correct. But all the writers are wanting, you know, wage increases because all their stuff is getting, you know, they would get like a $4,000 check if their stuff was being played on broadcast TV, but if it's on Netflix or whatever, they're getting a $4 check a month or, you know, some $24 check a month. So their Netflix premium ad-free in the United States went up to $22.99, and this is back in October. It's one stream basic plan was $11.99, and then they introduced a $6.99 ad supported plan as well. So they I'm thinking of getting rid of Netflix too because it's got some good stuff on there, but
it does have some good shit. Yeah,
it's essentially just Tubi that you pay for because it's
right.
There's not a lot of like really good shows. Like back in the day, you had like Orange is the New Black, House of Cards, and those are, you know, for me, I like those shows. And those are things that you would look forward to. And, you know, I don't see a lot of that kind of stuff anymore. And, you know, the writers, you know, they deserve their due as well. So they got to get paid. And this is one way. I don't think the price increase is done. I think it's going to go up a lot more.
Yeah, when do people stop? That's the question. I don't know when they'll eventually run out of money. You think they'd almost be out now. Because I don't, but I was telling Karen before we started this show, I don't know how much we exactly spent. Because, I mean, I know we spent a lot, but I don't remember in a year in the flow of living how much I spent on DVDs and CDs. I don't remember exactly. So I don't know, but you did own it, technically. So this one you're renting perpetually.
Exactly.
I don't know. It's hard, man. Like, I don't know if we've hit that. And then also, you can just have it for a month and cancel. But, you know, that's coming. I don't know when. They're definitely going to do cancellation fees. Like, you have to sign up for a year. If you cancel, it's $100 termination fee. You know that's coming.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
They're definitely going back to cable 2.0, which is kind of funny. It's like, I remember everyone was like, yeah, we did it, man. Streaming service. This is liberation. And these fuckers. And I saw it years ago. I'm like,
We called it on the show.
Like, we called it on Blabbercast. People listen. But yeah, it's fine. I'm like, you're not going to, it's corporations. You're not liberating anything. So,
yeah, they're going to weasel. It's like a greasy little, you know, Italian guy with a hairy chest and a gold chain. He's going to try and weasel his way back into your pants. It's just corporations. Mm-hmm. Sorry. Sorry, little Italian guys.
Sorry. It's okay. That's true, though. I mean, I get it. They have to make their money. I do understand that. But for me, it's like, I think, I've just decided once I, you know, get some flow, I'm just going to start buying DVDs again. Yeah, I just don't have to watch the show. I'm like, do I really need to watch all this shit now? Do I need to watch this massive amount of fucking content, air quotes? I don't need to, of course. I don't know. I just watch old movies.
That's an excellent fucking point. What was her name? Danica something or... Comic Book Girl 19, I don't know if she came up with the phrase, but she mentioned content fatigue once, like a couple years ago, one of her videos. And I was like, holy shit, that's exactly right. There's like, I was paying something like 60, 70 bucks a month for streaming services. Cause I had like Disney, Hulu, Netflix, Prime, that's something else. And, YouTube Premium, I guess. And, I would really only stick to like one or two of them.
And that's what I would do. Yeah. Same.
Mm-hmm. You know, there's not enough hours in the day to sit there and watch everything.
That's what I'm saying. How much can y'all fucking watch? It's like, another show. It's like, well, yeah, that's a little bit long. Cause back in there was Friends, Seinfeld, and then everything was pretty much a movie for the most, you know, there were some shows, but everything was a movie. So it was faster to get through.
Yeah,
but everyone wants shows, and it's like, well, it takes quite a bit to get through that, and I just get bored watching them. Like, not all of them. I mean, Game of Thrones is awesome, Dexter was awesome. There's certain things, but yeah, Weeds. A lot of times I'm sitting there like, Weeds was funny, but I'm sitting there like, here we go, this is set up, and this is backstory shit. I don't care. I start going on the computer, I just lose interest in them.
You need to make
it special, and it's not special if it just keeps happening over and over and over again. That's, I think that's where they've hit now.
Yeah, I think I only have like two or three streaming services now. I'm going to cut down another one, and I had some like other subscriptions that I was doing. Like I got like this mushroom coffee stuff. I think I told you about it, Billy. And that was like 30 bucks a month, and
Everything's a subscription.
Yeah, with all the
people theming their fucking iPhone and Androids for fucking, there's a fucking subscription fee for that. Like, you're paying a subscription to theme your fucking phone?
Yeah, I know.
And a lot of reviews, people are doing it. I'm like, why?
That boggles me. Like, that.
It's a mind blowing.
It's like, I need.
It's two people that worked on that.
I need to come up with a subscription for a screwdriver, you know?
They love them.
Yeah, it's fucking nuts. But I saved, I think, like $65 a month just by cutting out like three things. You know, I had a, like a Patreon subscription for a guitar player guy, the mushroom thing, the Hulu, and I cut something else out. And like, I haven't even, like, once I get rid of fucking Netflix, that's going to be like another $18, $15, whatever it is. Or I guess $12. Because I've got the lower
savings.
And that's nearly $100 a month liquid cash in my, you know, pocket. And it's like, it's just a lot of money. I mean, it would be nice to have that kind of time to be able to watch all that stuff. But I don't think that if I had that time, I would be sitting around watching that stuff.
Well, yeah, then I feel depressed.
Yeah,
exactly. Man, I'm doing shit. I'd rather play a video game or something like that. Well, those got longer too, by the way. So it's like 100 hours. God. I'm like, fuck me, man. It's, everything is over. Everything is blown up.
I think the last Assassin's Creed game I played was Odyssey.
Yeah, you kept saying, you were like, I'm playing this. I'm like, damn, you've been playing that for like 8 months. It felt like it.
I logged something like close to 300 gameplay hours in that thing. And I barely scratched. I bought two DLCs. I only touched the first one. Like, I haven't even gone through all the there's like three or four DLCs for it. I only got two of them. And I didn't even scratch the surface of the first one. And I have 300 hours on that thing. And I bought Valhalla and I played 5 minutes of it. And it's like, I can't. And that was like years ago. They're so big and so like repetitive that it was just like, I gotta spend a couple years away from this thing. So
yeah, when you told me about it, I was just like, I was gonna, I don't want to buy it. I didn't want to buy it. It turned me off from buying it. So and there was random shit I heard. No, 7, like Skyrim or something. I'm like, yeah, there was outlier games that you play for a lot of hours. That's fine. But now it's they're all we're getting like that, and not all of them, but a lot. And yeah, there's only so much fucking time, you know, to go through all that shit.
There are exceptions, like, it's weird. Assassin's Creed was always a game that I really loved and got into, but by the time I stopped playing, I was fucking sick of it.
Yeah, like, same. Yeah, I get tired of it. Yeah.
Something like Fallout, Red Dead Redemption 1 and 2, Grand Theft Auto 5 or, you know, San Andreas or whatever. All those games I you know, still I loved. I remember I took I took 2 weeks vacation to play Fallout 4. And I just fucking, I did nothing but play that game. And it was the best vacation of my life.
I know. It does work sometimes. Yeah. To chill out. Yeah, sure. But yeah, it's just, that's the way, I mean, it's the way things are. I mean, like, if I could pick things from now, there's some cool shit, but if, honestly, to say you're going back to 2003, everything's gonna be the same as it was though. Phones, you're not gonna have any of this shit. You gotta buy CDs again. I'm like, yeah, I'm totally fine with that.
I've started buying DVDs and CDs again.
I just said to you, one, but hey, I need your CDs. I'm gonna rip them. All right, cool. Thanks. Bring it back to you next day. All right, thanks, bro. Now I got the CDs. I got all my music. That's easy. An iPod this time so I don't scratch everything up. And then so I didn't get one last time. I don't know why I didn't get an iPod. I don't understand that. But, you know, and then DVDs, I could easily stock up on that. But I would definitely rip a lot more shit. But, yeah, I would choose back then because it felt more special to me. But the positive side to being overly negative is, like, yeah, more people get a chance to get their act and get their shit out there, which is cool. So that's cool. I mean, that is a positive for sure.
Absolutely, yeah.
So there's that. But Black Friday coming up and Thanksgiving, which we talked about. You excited? Is anyone excited out there?
Excited about Black Friday?
I don't have a lot of money, so I'm not. So every Black Friday, I've always said, man, once I've had like, you know, a whole bunch of some good flow and cash. Like this year again, I'm like, I don't really have the flow and cash. I don't want to just, yeah, I can buy a whole bunch of shit, but then I end up like, shit, I just spend $1,000. I shouldn't do that. So
yeah,
I might as well take it easy this year.
I
don't really care. I mean, I don't think there was as special as they used to be. I mean, there's deals all throughout the year, to be honest.
I've never really found, like in the last like 7 years, 8 years, I've never found a Black Friday that I was excited for, because I thought it used to be like everything was on sale. And then you had like a lot of stuff that was like super duper on sale, like TVs and stuff, but it turned, I don't know. It just seemed like the stuff that was like crazy on sale, you had to like camp out, you know, for 2 days before Black Friday, like totally miss Thanksgiving because you're sleeping in a tent in front of a Best Buy. So you can get, you know, 75 inch, you know, LED TV for a dollar or some shit.
Dollar,
you know,
the line. It would be the shittier one though. It would never be a good, like a really good one.
Like a Westinghouse.
It'd be like, it'd be an okay. Yeah. It'd be like something like that. I'm like, yeah, I'm not really waiting in line for that. I can, again, kind of live without it. Yeah. So.
Yeah. And it seems like you go and, you know, it's like, oh my God, they've got an amazing deal. Really? On what? You know, it's a blender. Well, what? I don't need a blender. I got
it. Yeah, no, there you go for everything. Yeah.
Yeah. But this was like 50 cents. Like, I don't care. I don't need it. Like, what? Well, I got 7. Why? I'm going to give them out of stocking stuffers. They don't fit in stockings, dude. You know, it never, like, if there's something I needed, I'd go there and it'd be full price. I'm like, what the fuck am I here for? Yeah. So I stopped like really caring. It's like you said, a lot of places, have their own, you know, deals and sales throughout the year. So it's pretty good. I remember 1 year I found this amp, this guitar amp, and I bought it. And it was a week before Black Friday. And the guy said, we don't have Black Friday sales, but I'll give you 10% off. And I looked at the guy and said, your store's going under. I'm going to walk out unless you increase it to 25%. He said, okay. I'm like, there you go. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Yeah. Then Thanksgiving, I guess, a holiday, since we'll be doing retrospectives at that point. So we'll wish you fuckers and then happy Thanksgiving, I'm sure. We'll have to do it again anyway. There will be like 20 people watch this. So maybe higher, we'll see. But like, we'll go down subscribers. How dare they make a topic video and not a retrospective?
Ew, not a retrospective. Gross.
I know.
That's YouTube herpes.
trending is YouTube herpes. I don't know how many views they get, and it's so fucking bad. But yeah, it's I don't know. I don't care. I mean, Thanksgiving's fine. I don't, but you know, the whole family thing. It's like I only see you once a year. We might as well just complete the set and make it zero. Yeah. I mean, like, why? It's like it's fine, but I've always kind of looked at it that way. Don't want to talk to me. Certain people in life, and it's just like, oh, it's like you have to do it. It's like, well, why? I mean, if you don't want to talk to the person, it's not wrong. I don't take that personally at all.
Yeah. It's like, you don't want to talk to me the whole year, but now you do.
Yeah. Fine. Just keep it going. Yeah. So let's complete the set. 365. We're good to go. Yeah.
No hard feelings. Just fuck off.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
We have one more. Goodbye. Thanks for your service. Exactly. We have one more thing we'll bring up, I guess. And yeah, hopefully we made it. I think we got a show out of it. So we're okay. But this one you had for about Buzzy.
Oh yeah. I heard about this and I started doing some research on it because it was kind of fascinating. Balls
Aldrin. Balls Aldrin.
Sorry, Buzz. I'm gonna call you that from now on. Balls Aldrin, the famous astronaut. Apparently, in December 7th, 2016, he went to Antarctica for some reason. And apparently, a lot of people go to the South Pole ish area. I guess the outer area of the place is like a big touristy spot. You can go on like cruises and stuff and see all the penguins and the whales and stuff, but that inner area is all kind of blocked off. You can't fly over it. You can't go there. It's controlled by a bunch of different governments and whatnot, and it's kind of like a, you know, in the conspiracy world, theory world, tinfoil hat brigade, they think that there's a whole bunch. Yeah, there's a numerous fucking conspiracy theory lines that go on and whatnot. But apparently Buzz Aldrin went there and he fell ill while he was there. He started getting some fluid buildup in his lungs. And he apparently sent a tweet that said, "We are all in danger. It is evil itself." And he sent a picture of like this mountain peak as well with his tweet. And it caused, sent everybody up in arm, well, you know, conspiracy theory guys and gals, yeah. Everyone started freaking out. It's like, what's going on there? And blah, 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 blah. But somebody noticed that the tweet looked a little weird. This is when I started to lose interest, is that apparently his blue check mark verification badge wasn't attached to it. And this is before the Elon Musk era of you have to pay for it thing, whether you like that or not. This is before that. So that was kind of a red flag. And then there was some other like color grading issues that kind of looked off.
It did look weird. Yeah.
So, you know, once they, you know, a lot
I'll
of
put it in the thing, it definitely looks blurry to what we have here, but it's okay.
Yeah. I couldn't get
this a looks good like picture. A weird mountain. I don't fucking know.
It does look like a weird mountain. There are people that have said that they see pyramids there, and this kind of looks like a pyramid, but
it does a little bit. No.
But the tweet was deleted. And so, yeah, I don't know if Buzz has ever been questioned about it or whatnot, but that alone kind of turned me off. But then there were other stories that I was hearing about people who served in Antarctica and like, you know, doctors that saw things and treated wounds from other staff that was assigned to the base in the South Pole. And they were, you know, treating wounds and what. All this shit could have been made up. You know, it could have just been, you know, someone trying to get a job at Netflix to write or something. But,
oh, yeah, totally.
Yeah, it piqued my interest and whatnot, because it is the one thing that the one question that I can't get answered is, why is the South Pole not allowed to be looked at? Like, why is it protected by military and governments? So. And it's not just
Earth's flat, bro.
Well, yeah, I think so. I mean, I think that's I think that is where you go to fall off the edge of the world. So
there you go.
But I
think, fall off.
I don't know. Honestly, I hate to say it for flat earthers, but cat owners have pretty much disproved that the world is flat. Did you hear about that? Mm-mm. Yeah. So if the earth was flat, cats would have knocked everything off of it already. So,
that's true.
So, yeah. All right, guys, that's going to wrap it up for us this week. Hope you enjoyed me and Billy just rambling, our rambling topic videos. Make sure you guys hit the like button, hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed, and if you already subscribed, hey guys, what's up? Hit us up on Twitter or X, whatever the fuck it's called right now, and let us know what streaming services you got, and if you're planning on getting any more, just curious. And in the description below, hit that link. That's going to take you to a place where you can buy my co-host book, The Nicest Parts of Hell. Get it three different versions, Kindle, Audible, paperback. All of them are excellent. I have all three. It is a hell of a read. Give it a shot. And with that, Billy, anything else?
That is all, sir. Next week is Event Horizon.
Event Horizon. Blending two of my favorite genres, sci-fi and horror. This is one hell of a movie. I can't wait to dive into this one. So looking forward to it.
Absolutely. And
with that said, ladies and gentlemen, you have a great week. Thanks for hanging out with us, and we'll see you later on. Happy Thanksgiving. Gobble, gobble, gobble.